Hello, my friends. This is Wake Angel 2001 coming at you with a review of a figure that I never thought I would actually find. It is the Walgreens exclusive Transformers Legacy Autobot Minerva. Yes, my mother found this at our local Walgreens just yesterday, which was incredibly fortuitous because as of right now, my Walgreens is having a sale where certain figures are 50% off in the post-holiday season, a sale which is only going to last until tomorrow, as of the time of this recording, you know, February 1st. But she came in literally 2 days before the sale ended. So her retail price of $19.99 was reduced by half, so we got her for only 10 bucks. Considering how people have been price gouging this thing and trying to scalp it online, finding one for such a low price was a great piece of catharsis for me. The box features some very nice artwork of her. Check her out on the side there. That is a very good picture of Minerva, along with a very nice headshot. Very nice, very nice. And the back of the box just features simple pictures of the figure itself. So, of course, I went ahead and took her out of the packaging so as to save some time. And she's looking good. I mean, you can say that she's basically just the Elita 1, but with a different paint job and a new head. And that is true. Let's bring in Elita 1 here just for point of comparison. So yeah, it is very much the same figure. All the same molding is in the same places. There are some different colors, but I'll get into that later. One thing you can do, of course, is to alter the way that the back kibble goes. That way you can have a different look for her, so she doesn't feel that much like a mold twin. You know, I like the fact that even though they are mold twins, like you can do a little bit of customizing. As you may recall, I did the same thing for the female Autobot team, where I just folded up their back kibble all in different ways to give them all a little bit of personality. But there is one little thing. It's in her instructions, which I found a little bit amusing. So this figure has a light bar accessory, which you can plug into the top, the same way that the original version of the mold had the little hat, like the little car hat for Elita 1. This one has a light bar, so it can be like an ambulance. But if you look closely at the picture of any instructions, that's Elita 1's little car hat. You know what I'm talking about, this thing. Yeah, that's a removable thing. Yeah. I just found it amusing that they did update the picture of the accessory. And if you look, that is Minerva's head in the picture. So they did update the picture. But despite updating this and updating this, they left that in. And if you look on the back of her head, that's still Minerva. So, like, they must have messed up in the CAD file and put the wrong part in there. Like, maybe when they were doing the CAD files, like, the Elita 1 piece was still back there, and they didn't notice it in the proofreading. Okay, so let's take a closer look at Minerva. That head sculpt is one of the only original pieces of sculpting, so we're going to take a closer look at it. And, yep, that is Minerva, all right. She's got her antenna, she has her orange face and blue eyes, she has that slender feminine physique. The head does look like it has a big old helmet, so it at least evokes the imagery of a headmaster, even though you can't take the head off because she does not have that headmaster gimmick, which is what the original Minerva would have been famous for. I still can't believe that they gave us Headmaster RC and they made Nautica a headmaster, but we didn't get a Titan Master of Minerva back when they were doing that gimmick in the toy line. Whatever. She would have probably just been another blur remold back then, so I'm happy that she actually gets a mold that looks more like her. In fact, I do believe Elita 1 was the pre-tool of her, like they had intended to make the Minerva, and Elita 1 was just the mass appeal version of it. Okay, so, she comes with two accessories, which are the exact same guns that Elita 1 came with, except they're painted different. They're both cast in completely transparent plastic. One of them is painted black. When you take it out of her hands, you can see the transparent handle. And the other is just left transparent. I hate when they do this. As you can see, you could barely even see it on the camera. Like, if you're going to do translucent weaponry, do translucent blue or basically any translucent color, because pure translucent sucks and I hate it. But yeah, she's cast in red and white now. She has some gray bits. Her fists and biceps are gray. Her legs are red, but if you bend her knees, you can see they're cast in white and then painted. That's pretty interesting. And of course, she has half a car on her back, but it all folds up reasonably well so that it doesn't throw her off too much. Although this hinge is a little loose. Like, did that? I feel like on my Elita version of the toy, that hinge isn't anywhere near as loose. But despite the fact that that back hinge that holds the kibble in place is a little looser, the joints on her legs are actually more stiff. They are more secure, and the figure, like, Elita 1 wasn't exactly loose, but this figure is tighter than Elita 1. So she can hold poses just fine. Like you don't have to worry about gravity pulling her legs down or anything. Maybe get an accessory stand for standing, things like that. But yeah, she is well articulated. Her joints all have good tolerances. She is a good, solid figure. No mold degradation here. So let's get her into her... like I said, her legs are cast white and painted red, but just because they painted large areas like that doesn't mean they skipped out on detail work, like her little crotch panel having all those blue lines and dots. The figure has an excellent paint job. She has her Autobot signal on her back. The light bar is made in translucent red plastic. She does have some translucent parts, any part that would hold, like, stress does not have translucent, is what I'm trying to say. So this is one of those figures I don't have to worry too bad about, you know, worrying about the issues of translucent plastic and how it can be fragile. So let's get her into her vehicle mode so we can see how this little sports car looks as an ambulance. And here it is! I don't think you're going to be taking an injured patient in one of these things, but I don't know, maybe it can be like some kind of emergency vehicle. Like, I'm sure there will be some need for like a high-speed sports car in the emergency vehicle catalog. Can't think of anything right now, but I'm sure there is one. Maybe to transport medical supplies at high speed to someplace, I guess. Let's get the guns off the sides so that we can just see the vehicle in its pure form. Got the little Autobot signal right there on the hood. The light bar is there. It is a peg-in thing. You can unpeg it if you want. And it has its own peg in the top, so you can actually peg something else in there. I can kind of fit Elita 1's little car hat in there. It's fun. But, it's basically just the Elita 1 car, but done up in white. So there's less big patches of paint, but, you know, the detail work does make up for it. So, like, you got that nice little red stripe going down the side, the little tamper graphing there. So, you know, like, there's no big patches of color, but the actual patterns, the actual design and paintwork, it's done pretty good. So, yeah. I don't like how the hubcaps aren't painted. That's just unpainted black plastic. And the only real flaw, like, those feet, like, there's no click point that keeps them in. So, like, they're fine, but then you move the vehicle a little bit, and if they touch something, they come undone. It's like somebody forgot to close the doors properly. Of course, that was a problem with the Elita 1 version of the mold as well, so I'm not going to blame Minerva for it. It's a very cute little car. The color scheme is nice. And I always did like this car. Like, it's always been a very cute car. It suits the character pretty well. And, you know, it's... I'm like, it might actually... Like I said, because this was This mold was originally meant to be her, and Yelena 1 was just the pre-mold. It actually suits her a little bit better for the character than it did for Yelena. Even though it worked fine for Yelena 2, don't get me wrong. There is one little thing with the paint match. I don't know how well it's showing up on camera, but the cast white plastic is a little bit duller than the plastic that had to be painted white. But considering how that's really only these panels here, it doesn't really throw off the lines of the car very much. So, yeah. Minerva, she's great. If you can get to a Walgreens that actually has her in stock, grab her. Because maybe next time they'll make another one that actually does incorporate the Headmaster gimmick. This is Wake Angel 2001 signing off.